again. Notice here, doing chapter 2 of Richard Boleslavsky's Acting, the first 6 lessons. The title of chapter 2 is Memory of Emotion. So, the main point in chapter 2 is about the use of affective memory. Just to summarize what I can recall from my reading of chapter 2, the creature has returned after a year to meet the teacher. The incident where she met him for the first time the year before has affected her. So she learned something from it. She learned the lesson on concentration, and she's applied some principles of it in her life. And in fact, there was like one dramatic or maybe comedic moment where she used her concentration and she almost got into an accident. And the teacher said, you know, that is the element of drama. So basically, what's the essence of drama? Basically that conflict. But the main point in chapter 2 is on affective memory. Just to summarize that again, her concern is that whenever she goes for auditions and whenever she goes for performances, plays, the people keep telling her that she lacks experience, and that affected her, and she's concerned that she lacks experience in theatre. But then the teacher, you know, counters a point by saying that no, you have all the experience you need. And what the teacher means by experience here is the experiences of her life, you know, all the years of her life. That is her experience. And she asks what he means by that. And so, you know, she says, she asks him, do you mean that I have to memorize my emotions? Then the teacher says, no, by God, no. So what he means is that, you know, he gives an example of a story of a couple who got married because when they were romantically together, they used to eat cucumbers. And then, you know, over the years of their marriage life, their married life, they went through difficulties, ups and downs. But whenever they feel, whenever they face some down times, they found that, you know, whenever they are served cucumbers, fresh cucumbers, and they eat the cucumbers, their happy memories come back again. And then that kind of resolve their marital problems consistently. Yeah, so, and the creature highlights to the teacher, one of the challenges in the current role that she's playing for is this character. She has to leave home to pursue an opportunity elsewhere for a better life. But, you know, she's conflicted because she loves her mother. She stays with her mother at home. She's conflicted, you know. But at the same time, she's happy to get the opportunity, but she's also sad to leave her mother, right? And the director and herself also thinks that she has to choose between one or the other, one emotion or the other, happiness or sadness, right? But the teacher, being the contrarian that he is, says that you can be both. And how can she be both? So he got her to do an exercise in affective memory, right? He gets her to recall a moment in her life where she faced something similar, where she had to leave her brother or something, that she was excited to go somewhere, but she also had to leave her brother, and she felt a mixture of both happiness and sadness, right? So when he got her to go through this affective memory exercise, which is also, you know, has elements of the sensory exercise as well, getting her to recall a specific exact details of the memories that she can, so that these details can draw out the emotions that she felt during those moments. And then he got her to stick to those emotions, okay, to like still have those emotions, don't let those emotions go, like while she's in the high or in the flow of those emotions, right? Say her lines as this character that she's playing to her mother, right? So this is basically the process of using affective memory to draw out the emotions of the particular scene that, you know, the actor is supposed to play. But it's not just that, there's always like different elements that have to come to play, right? Before that, okay, in the first place, do you know what emotions you should display, or you know what emotions you should be trying to convey in the scene? So for that, to know that, you need to know the context as well, and you need to do some background research, you know, on the character, and also to make certain decisions, you know, whether it's logical to display this emotion or that emotion or this mixture of emotions, whether it's logical in the entire context of the play according to you and according to your character, according to the truth of your character, you know, whether, you know, this particular emotion that you want to draw out is the best choice, you know, given all the other different choices, right? So if once you've decided on that particular emotion, then you have to use affective memory to generate you know, that appropriate emotion out. Okay, this, how it relates to my personal life is that, you know, in the 35 years of my life, I've gone through a lot of experiences. I've gone through loss of loved ones, heartbreaks, tragedies, happiness, successes and failures, travel adventures, these kind of things. You know, it's, I would say I have quite a rich experience, a rich arsenal of experiences I can draw on and I can tap on. Right. So that to me is an advantage. Like, I sometimes feel at 35 years of age, I'm not starting from a young age, kind of old, but I'm not that old yet. So I still have an advantage. Like, 35 years, it's a long time. From the moment of my first recallable memory is probably around 5 years old. So I have like 30 years of life experiences to tap on. Like, 30 years of emotions I can tap on to add life and authenticity to the roles I potentially play, right? And I have a long way to go, you know, assuming I take care of my health and I still have a long life to live ahead of me. So yeah, that's a motivational thought. And the other point I want to relate to this is that this exercise of affective memory somehow reminds me of a concept in NLP or neuro-linguistic programming, which I believe maybe some of you or many of you who are into motivation coaching or self-help industries might be familiar with or have read about. Basically, the concept of anchoring, which also relates to a so-called scientific concept of Pavlovian response. So basically, just a primer, the Pavlovian response is basically some researchers or scientists, they tested on animals whereby they ring a bell when they serve food, and such that when they serve the food, right, so the animals will start to salivate. So they do this a couple of times such that the animals' brains make an association between the ringing of the bell and the food being served. And then they start to remove the food from the equation. They just ring the bell, and the animals still salivate with the ringing of the bell in the absence of the food, right? So, and then the NLP writers or NLP creators, they relate this to the concept of anchoring, whereby if you are in a down state, you want to be motivated, you want to be inspired, you want to be happier before a presentation or before you get on stage to perform something or present something, or you just, you know, want to be in a better state than you are now. What you do is you recall a good memory, or you recall a series of good memories, and you do this often, and you associate those good memories with a certain simple gesture like snapping of your fingers or putting your fingers in a certain way, you know, or pinching your hand probably, right? Such that when you do this often enough, the emotions, the flood of emotions, get associated with that gesture. So the next time you don't have to go through the whole entire cycle of trying to recall that memory, but by just doing that simple gesture, those flood of emotions will come freely, right? I've tried this with varying levels of success the past 3 years, and I kind of like drifted away from believing in NLP, but I think there's some basis in there. I guess you need to regularly practice it, yeah. just like this can be one of the arsenals in the tools of an actor in terms of the physical, mental, spiritual, maybe on the mental and spiritual preparation, right? How you be the best that you can be by accessing a state of mind and a state of being that is the most optimal for what you want to do. Yeah, so there's a positive aspect of it, and in the same time, I'm not sure how this can work in terms of like you want to, maybe the role requires you to convey a very sad, sorrowful, or angry emotion, right? The negative associations with it, if you like, you know, maybe you anchor those negative emotions with a snap of a finger, you know, how that might affect the actor psychologically. So it's important also for us to know when to turn this on and when to turn this off when it's necessary. Yeah. So maybe like you have a backup kind of gesture whereby there's always the default go-to when you want to feel good, right? So after you've gone through all those negative stuff, the flow of negative emotions, and you want to sort of wipe out that negative stuff already once your performance is over, you can just go back to your like positive anchoring gesture that triggers that, you know, flow of positive emotions. Or something else, you know, maybe you guys can offer some ideas. Yeah, thank you. This has been 13 minutes. I'll see you next week.